The death of singing star Whitney Houston at the age of 48. Details are still coming in at this hour, but her publicist confirms to ABC News that she has died, although the circumstances and the place of Whitney Houston's death are still unclear at this hour. She shot to fame in the 1980s with one of the most powerful and unforgettable voices we'd ever heard. She had hit record after hit record, from Saving All My Love for You to Right There, I Will Always Love You. It gives you the chills. She won Grammys and made hit movies along the way, including The Bodyguard and Waiting to Exhale. 55 million records sold in the U.S. alone, and Whitney Houston influenced a generation of other singers, from Mariah Carey to Christina Aguilera. Her success was hurt, as many of you know, by her long and very public struggle with drugs. She admitted using cocaine, marijuana, and pills, and she told her Diane Sawyer in that interview 10 years ago that, quote, "The biggest devil is me. I'm either my best friend or my worst enemy." The Hollywood Reporter says Whitney Houston was set to make an appearance tonight at the gala ahead of tomorrow night's Grammy Awards, and that she was last seen at the Beverly Hilton Hotel on Thursday. She had recently been working on a new album in the last couple of years, had been working on a comeback. It's believed that the crime lab is now at the Beverly Hilton Hotel, where reportedly Whitney Houston's body was found. We had reported earlier this evening that was the last place she was seen alive. She was to have performed at a Clive Davis gala tonight before the Grammy Awards. Reporting on the death of Whitney Houston at the age of 48 tonight. And I'm joined on the telephone by ABC News contributor Chris Conley. And Chris, you and I were talking during the break about I Will Always Love You, which is playing right here on the screen. It gives you chills to watch it now. And we all remember that 1991 Star Spangled Banner performance at the Super Bowl. The Gulf War had just started. I mean, this was a voice that defined a generation for America.
Absolutely the greatest voice of its generation, David, which is why I think the pain is so great about its loss tonight. We knew that Whitney Houston had deep personal demons. She'd been upfront about her struggles with drugs and substance abuse, had taken steps to rectify that, had tried that comeback tour a couple of years ago, but the voice didn't quite sound the same. And now it's sad to think that we'll never get to hear that voice again.
Yeah, the voice didn't sound the same, but so many, including myself, rooting for her. She had told Diane Sawyer in that now infamous interview 10 years ago that, quote, "The biggest devil is me. I'm either my best friend or my worst enemy." She was able to sum up her own struggles very publicly.
Yeah, and I think everybody, as you say, was rooting for her. No one more than Clive Davis, who discovered her, who crafted that great first record, who was always her champion, who brought her back with that comeback record, and at whose pre-Grammy party tonight she was apparently scheduled to sing. So the loss is incalculable for what we'll never get to hear.
She was also loved for her work in Hollywood on movies like The Bodyguard, Waiting to Exhale, 55 million records sold, and I Will Always Love You, by the way, was written and first performed by Dolly Parton, and even Parton through the years said she was stunned by Whitney Houston's rendition of her own song. So many of us were, remembering Whitney Houston at the age of 48, dead in Los Angeles. We will have much more on this first thing in the morning on Good Morning America. I'm sorry to bring you the bad news tonight. I'm David Muir.